Okay, we begin this part of the massage by rolling the towel up to the knees and oiling up both of the lower legs. And then when you're ready, you effleurage up both legs together 2 or 3 times. And then decide which of the feet you want to work on first. And remember, in between each of these elements, you need to put in a nice long effleurage stroke up to the knee. So we start by massaging around the ankle joint. And then we follow this by stretching out the toes, so we sort of splay the toes. Come round to the side of the table for the flip-flap stroke. And then it's massaging the inner and outer borders of the foot in turn, using the heel of your hand. Go on to massaging each of the toes. And then we massage and drain down in between the tendons. And when we've done that, we move on and massage the sole with the heel of your hands, your knuckles and your thumbs. Thank you. going to knead along the Achilles tendon, all the way up to the gastrocnemius. And then we're going to ring the foot. And then move on to the passive rotation of the toes. Followed by the passive rotation of the ankles. Okay, then put in some effleurage strokes up both legs together. Move around and perform exactly the same strokes on the other foot. So we start with massaging around the ankle joint. Stretching out the toes. Round to the side of the table for the flip-flap stroke. Transition into massaging the inner and outer borders of the foot in turn. Then we massage each of the toes in turn. Follow this by draining down in between the tendons. And it's working into the sole of the foot with the heel of your hand, your knuckles and your thumbs. Then we're going to massage into the Achilles tendon. Follow this with wringing the foot. Then passive rotation of the toes. And then passive rotation of the ankles. Okay, put in more effleurage up both legs to the knee a couple of times. Then you're going to roll the towel up to the top of the hips and oil up both upper legs. Okay, then we start with effleurage of both legs together. And then bring to sort of work into the hips as you come up the table. Repeat this one more time. Then we're going to transition into the circular stroke on the leg opposite from you. So up the leg furthest from you. Working first on the calf. Start at a slow pace, build it up to a faster rhythm, and then back down to a slower pace. Move up and do the same on the thigh. And then we're going to slide across to the inner leg nearest to you. And repeat the same process. So working on the inner thigh this time, start at a slow pace, build up the rhythm and speed, slow down once more, transition to the lower calf nearest to you, and do the same. Then it's more effleurage of both legs together. before we repeat the circling on the other side of the body. Okay, and then we put in effleurage arch up both legs together a couple of times. And then we're going to drain each leg in turn a couple of times. So remember a nice firm strokes up the lower leg, easing off over the knee, then firmer pressure once again into the thigh for working into the hip with the heel of your hand. Slide down and round the stroke off down the side of the legs and repeat one more time. This time stopping at the knee and working around the kneecap. Okay, a couple of effleurage strokes at both legs together. And then we're going to repeat the draining stroke on the other leg. Right, and put in two more long effleurage strokes up both legs together. And we're going to finish this part of the massage by grasping both ankles and by using your body weight, lean back to perform a nice stretch on the legs. Okay, and roll the towel back over the legs. And maintaining contact, move to the head of the table and roll down the towel to the hips and apply oil to the upper chest, the arms and hands, and the abdomen. Okay, when everything's nicely oiled up, we begin with effleurage to the upper chest, the shoulders and the arms. When you've done this a couple of times, you're going to transition into doing the circling stroke on the opposite side of the abdomen from you. Transition around to the other side of the table and repeat the circling on the other side of the abdomen. Okay, at this stage, you can cover the abdomen, but leave the arms and the hands exposed. Okay, choosing which arm and hand you want to work on first. You're going to drain along the arm, around the shoulder, and when you get back to the hand, give the arm a nice stretch. Repeat this one more time. And then you're going to place the arm across your client's chest and drain down the upper arm. Remembering to lift as you glide back up. And then going to extend the arm above the client's head and supporting it at the at your wrist and their elbow, drain down the inner arm a couple of times. We're going to return the arm to the table to begin the hand massage. Firstly, we're going to massage around the wrist. Put in a nice long stroke up the elbow, as in between all the other elements. And then you're going to stretch out the fingers. And then we're going to massage each of the fingers in turn. Then we're going to drain down between the tendons. To turn the hand over and massage the palm of the hand with your thumbs. And then support the back of the hand and massage into the palm with your knuckles. Okay, then I'm going to perform the passive rotation of the wrist, taking it through its natural movements in a clockwise and anti-clockwise direction. then stretch it forward, hold, and then back and hold. And then we're going to transition round to the other side of the table to perform the same strokes on the other arm. So we start by draining along the arm and around the shoulders. As you come back, you give the arm a nice stretch. Repeat this one more time. Place the arm across the client's chest and drain down the upper arm. And then you're going to extend the arm above the client's head and drain down the inner arm. Turn the arm to the table to begin the hand massage. So we start again by massaging around the wrist. And then you're going to stretch the fingers. Massage each of the fingers in turn. And then drain down in between the tendons. Then we're going to turn the hand over and massage into the palm with your thumbs. And then supporting the back of the hand, we're going to use our knuckles to massage into the palm. Follow this with a passive rotation of the wrist in a clockwise and anti-clockwise direction. Then stretch it forwards. Back. place the arm back onto the table. Transition to the head of the table. And you're then going to perform the circular stroke over the sternum. All of this with the shoulder push down onto the couch. And then along the couch. Okay, place both of your clients' arms onto their torso. And then grabbing their wrists, stretch the arms above their head and use your body weight to lean back to get a full body stretch. Right, at this stage you can replace the arms under the towel and prepare for the head, neck and face massage. So from the head of the table, put in a couple of gentle effleurage strokes across the upper chest and round the shoulders and into the neck before very gently lifting the head to one side. And effleuraging down the neck, round the shoulders, right up into the base of the neck. And repeat this 2-3 times. Follow this with kneading into the base of the neck. And using your finger pads in small circular movements, move over this area of the scalp, moving the skin against the underlying bone. Okay, when you've covered this side of the head, gently move the head back to the centre and then across to the other side, and repeat these movements. So we begin by effleuraging down the neck, around the shoulders, right up into the neck once more. Repeat this 2 or 3 times. And it's kneading again around the base of the skull with your fingers and thumb. And then using the pads of your fingers to work over the side of the head. Nice circular movements where you're moving the skin against the underlying bone. Slowly going to move the head back to the centre, and this time you're going to stretch the head towards the chest, going only as far as is comfortable for the client to get a nice stretch along the back. And then with the weight of the head in your hands, you're going to use alternative effleurage strokes along the back of the neck, before gently placing it back onto the table. We then begin the head massage, the face massage that is, by working across the forehead with our thumbs in 3 strips from the hairline to the eyebrows, circling each time at the temples. Follow this by using our fingers and thumbs to knead along the eye line, eyebrow. Again, circling at the temples. Thumbs down the side of the nose and around the cheekbone. Once more, circling at the temples. And we follow this by using the pads of our fingers to again follow along the cheekbone. Circling once more at the temples. Follow this with Topotamon over the cheeks and the forehead. encircling at the temples. And then we're going to knead along the jawline out from the center all the way along. Draw our fingers across the cheeks and take the stroke up to the back of the ears and start to massage the ears. Knead the ears with our fingers and thumb. And cup your hands over the ears. Time move them to cup the eyes and then you have to draw your fingers through the hair giving gentle tugs to stimulate the hair follicles. Make sure that the towel is covering the shoulders. And keeping contact. Move to the side of the table. And recenter before finishing the massage.